한식, 맵기만 하다고? 풍미가 넓고 깊더라. 지난 한식대첩 고수회전에 출연한 외국 톱셰프 5인이 이구동성으로 한 말입니다. 각 나라 톱셰프인 이들이 한식에 대해 한 말들을 모아 간략히 정리해보면 다음과 같습니다. 한국에 와서 맛본 한식은 해외에서 먹던 한식과 전혀 다르다. 한식은 맵고 달기만 할 줄 알았는데 진짜 한식은 매우 깔끔하고 섬세하다. 한식은 풍미가 깊고 넓다. 진짜 한식은 맛의 균형감이 뛰어나다. 단순히 맵기만 한 게 아니라 복합적인 맛이다. 이러한 한식의 맛으로 세계를 매혹시킨 톱셰프가 있습니다. 그 사람은 바로 한국계 미국인 요리사 주디쥬입니다. 주디쥬는 셰프 오디션 TV 프로그램 아이언 셰프 영국편에 출연하여 여성 셰프 최초로 우승을 거머쥐어 세계적인 인지도를 얻게 되었습니다. 그 이후 미국으로 건너와 다음과 같은 요리 프로그램에서 심사위원으로 활약하게 되면서 명성을 널리 떨치게 됩니다. 또한 다음과 같은 TV 요리 방송도 진행했습니다. 이 중 2014년 4월 시즌1을 시작으로 시즌3까지 제작 방영된 코리안 푸드 메이드 심플은 미국, 호주, 유럽, 중국, 동아시아 등 전 세계 15개국에서 방영되었습니다. 주디쥬는 처음부터 요리의 길을 걸은 요리사가 아니었습니다. 주디쥬는 뉴저지의 한국인 이민자 가정에서 태어났습니다. 의사였던 아버지와 화학자였던 어머니 밑에서 자랐으며 뉴욕의 명문대학인 컬럼비아 대학에서 공학을 전공했습니다. 졸업 후 세계적인 금융회사 모건 스탠리에서 일하면서 재정적 풍족을 누렸지만 꿈을 찾기 위해 회사를 그만두고 새로운 길을 걷게 됩니다. 화학자인 어머니의 영향으로 한때 과학자의 꿈을 꾸기도 했던 주디쥬는 자신이 요리에 더 흥미를 느끼고 있음을 발견합니다. 그래서 과학자 같은 요리사가 되고자 합니다. 요리와 과학은 통하는 데가 많다고 생각한 주디쥬는 요리학교를 졸업 후 실험 주방에서 일하게 됩니다. 변수를 통제하고 각 재료가 어떤 영향을 끼치는지 이해하고 온도의 높고 낮음을 계산하고 베이킹소다의 성분을 분석하는 등 과학자가 하는 일과 다를 바 없이 연구했습니다. 그렇게 주디쥬는 과학을 바탕으로 한 요리사로 거듭나게 되고 미국과 영국의 요리방송 및 요리대결 프로를 장악해버립니다. 최고의 요리사로 명성을 떨치는 주디쥬가 만들어준 김치와 보쌈을 맛본 미국 방송인들은 어떤 반응을 보였을까요? 여러 방송 중 두 방송을 일부 발췌하여 번역해보았습니다. 함께 보시죠.
Amazing cooking.
Yeah, what are we going to do?
So I made two dishes. The first one is bosam, which is Korean pork belly.
Bosam.
Okay. But I'm going to start out with the cornerstone of Korean cooking.
Hey, why is this the cornerstone?
It's kimchi.
Kimchi.
Oh, and it's not because it's just on the corner.
No.
On the table. Okay.
And have you ladies had kimchi before?
Not like this, but I mean...
Not like this, yeah. But I love kimchi. Do you love kimchi?
I do because it's got like natural... It's the fermented thing, and that's so good for our bodies.
Superfood. Digestion.
Superfood. It's fortified in vitamins, and also, it tastes amazing.
You.
And so, you're seeing kimchi pop up on menus all over right. the place right
At
now.
Some it of is my vegetarian, like favorite vegan vegetarian restaurants, kimchi is on the menu. Not really good for you, but.
Yeah, so you can have vegetarian kimchi. There's usually fish sauce or some kind of shrimp paste involved.
Mm. Oh, I like the little, the zing zing.
Yes.
I like
the zing zang.
The zing
zang.
Spicy.
Zang. What's the zing zang?
The zing zang is this. This is the Korean chili flake called gochugaru.
Oh, and ooh, it is.
That sounds
so nice.
Gochugaru.
I love gochugaru. It.
It's very exciting.
It is. It's its own chili. It's actually its own Korean species. And so it has its own flavor, heat, as well as sweetness, earthiness, smokiness.
My mouth is having a party right
now. It definitely is. And you're saying kimchi being the cornerstone, you have it at every meal?
Every
meal. Doesn't matter if it's breakfast?
No. Breakfast, lunch, dinner,
really?
365 days a year.
And is it before the main meal, after?
It's a side dish. Okay. So you eat it with other dishes. But this is the secret food that kept them healthy because of the immunity boost of kimchi.
I'm going to start.
Yes, more kimchi.
Every day. Everybody, all of us.
So we'll start doing more kimchi, but right now my eye is going here.
This is bosam. So
right?
this is cooked.
Yeah.
It's a two-part cooking technique. So you boil it first with lots of great Asian aromatics like ginger, garlic, onions, scallions, all of that great stuff to kind of infuse it. And it gets really soft for about 2 to 3 hours.
Nice.
And then I bake it in the oven. I roast it off and I put a glaze on top.
So it's glazing.
It's glazing. So this is like a sweet and spicy, really savory, almost, if you know the word umami.
Umami.
Umami. It's that addictive quality that makes everything taste
amazing. So much today.
Yes, yes. So it's kind of like the other taste that makes you just want to eat things over and over again.
Nice.
Yeah. So this has that addictive umami quality.
Umami. We're working with the umami.
Exactly.
You can't stop just after one.
No, you have to eat the entire thing.
So shall we do some tasting?
I hate that. Yeah, it's time to taste because we have to construct this.
Tell us how to do this.
You watch and learn. It's very easy. So you take a nice crisp lettuce leaf.
And is this butter lettuce? What kind of lettuce is this?
Yeah, this is butter lettuce.
Okay, great.
But you can use any kind, you know. But just something, and it gives it a nice contrast. Mm-hmm. It's cool, it's crispy. And then a little bit of rice.
Nice.
So nice with the black sesame seeds on top of it.
Thank you, thank you.
Food so always has to look beautiful.
Like, can I put this on next, or is there a certain order?
Nope, there's no order there.
And
no
this
rules.
Is the sauce.
That is the schmear that you put on top.
And I can have this, right?
You
there's
can
any
have
meat
that.
In there.
Nope, and then you are going to eat this.
And I'm going to eat this.
You go for the pork, right?
Yes, you go for the pork.
I'll go for the kimchi.
Now, I like that you're saying that it looks beautiful. You've got lots of different colors, but also all that flavor, all of the different spices. This is my first. Thank you so much. And what do we call this exactly?
This is bosam.
This is it. The whole thing together is bosam. Thank you so much. I love it. I truly do.
Food made simple.
It is. We've never done anything like this in the kitchen.
She's an Iron Chef who's obviously having a great time.
Yep. About her new cooking channel show, Korean Food Made Simple, is Chef Judy Ju.
Thank
Welcome
you.
Welcome to Arise 360, girl.
Thank you. Yes. Thank you.
But we're going to get to that. But before we do, you have to tell us about how you're going to be making Korean food simple for television.
Yes.
So it's lots of shortcuts, because Korean food is one of those cuisines that was designed to keep the women in the kitchen.
It is
a conspiracy. So I don't have all day, you know, and I definitely don't want to be cooking and slaving away in the kitchen all day long on all night. So I've taken a lot of shortcuts. And plus, I don't feel that the cuisine has to be absolutely authentic for you to get the true essence of the Korean flavors. Mm. And once you get a little taste of Korea, you're going to be addicted.
I love your Korean barbecue.
Oh, yeah.
We're actually in Koreatown. The studio is in Koreatown. So there are all these fabulous Korean restaurants around us. So we're so excited to have you here.
Yeah.
And you're the only female Iron Chef in the UK?
Yes.
Go, girl.
Yeah.
That's impressive.
Good. Yeah, it's good.
You know, mentioned Korean food. It seems like it's becoming more and more popular here in the U.S. Mm-hmm. What does that do to? What's causing the rise in popularity?
People are just getting a flavor, a taste, and it's spreading like a wave.
So,
you know, it's kind of funny, because Korea, everybody knows all the great companies, like Samsung and Hyundai and Daewoo and everything, but nobody really knows anything about Korean culture. Mm. And so with this show, just kind of showing people, you know, like, this is Korean food. Yeah.
That's true, and one of the best ways to know a culture is through their food.
So let's get eating. Well, I guess we have to make it first. So what are we making?
We're going to make kimchi, which is Korea's national dish.
Mm-hmm.
It's always on the table. It's first now. We're going to start at step one. I've taken cucumbers. So this is a variation of kimchi. Mm-hmm. There are 187 different official varieties of kimchi. You can kimchi most fruits and vegetables, which is great. I actually turn it into a verb so you can kimchi things.
I like that.
And so I'm going to show you how to kimchi cucumber.
Okay.
And I've gotten here nice little Kirby cucumbers. Mm-hmm. They're hard. They're smaller. So there isn't a lot of water in these.
Okay.
They're not like the big fat ones.
So that's one shortcut.
Exactly.
Okay.
And just some salt on top.
Coarse salt. Okay.
So this is going to kind of brine it and draw some of that water out.
Okay.
Right? And you let that sit for about an hour.
Okay.
So it just kind of extracts it. And then the magic of television.
Yes.
Then we've got these, which I've made ahead of time. And you see that they're a little bit wilted.
Yeah.
They're not as crunchy, but they're still crisp, you know?
Mm-hmm.
And then we're going to put our kimchi paste.
Okay. I've used
some authentic ingredients, but you can always mix and match. And I do believe in substitutions. Like, a lot of people think that in order to get a taste of a culture, you have to make it absolutely authentic. I'm like, no. Shortcuts, substitution.
Yeah. So what is the shortcut we're doing right now?
This is just regular onion.
Okay, regular. Just throw them in.
I'm going to throw that in. Yeah.
Okay, that works.
And I've got a little...
Good old yellow onion. Okay.
Yeah, Asian aromatics. So this is some ginger.
Okay.
And
Love some garlic.
Garlic.
Really good for you. Winning combination. These are actually really good antioxidants. So there's lots of vitamins and things like that. Now this,
what
if you can't
that?
Find this, you can substitute with just regular fish sauce. But because we're here and I have it, we're in New York City, you can get this easily in New York City.
And what's it called?
This is called saojut, which is salted shrimp. This is going to give you like depth and complexity. And most Asian cultures use some type of form of shrimp paste or salted shrimp or something.
Okay.
And this is what gives you a lot of great flavor.
All right, it gives you the kick.
It gives you flavor. It gives deepness, yeah.
Okay.
The kick is this
Ooh,
this.
Now, what's that?
Korean chili flakes. Gochugaru.
So is it going to be spicy?
This is spicy.
Okay.
Oh, spicy. It's about living life, being spicy.
Jump it on in. Let's do it. Spice up our life.
Yeah. Do you like spicy food?
Yes, I do. Yes. Okay, the spicier, the better. Okay. I do. I love it. And I like it hot.
And to balance the spice, a little bit of sugar.
Okay. Sugar and spice. Everything nice.
So Korean food is really all about balancing everything out.
Okay.
And just to make it a paste, just a little bit of water.
Okay.
Okay, so I'm just going to dump some of that in.
And then we just get
blend
the,
it on up.
It's a party going on in
it
there.
Is.
It's a kimchi party.
So I'm
going
to scoop some of that on. It is a kimchi party. Mm-hmm. Actually, I have a kimchi party on my show.
You do?
Really?
Oh, my God. Invite us to your next
sounds
one.
Like fun.
Yeah, because one of the things about making kimchi is that everybody gets together and makes it together. So it's one of these like things that you do with all.
Dish.
Yeah,
like
it is. It is. You kind of get together with all the women around and you have a kimchi party. I'm just pushing it inside the cucumbers because I made little crosses in them. So that's
inside.
It.
That's
and then,
it?
And then a few days, you have your finished product.
Now you say a few days, you're supposed to let it sit
you
for a while?
You let it ferment. Oh. And the fermentation is what makes it so healthy. It's full of all those probiotics and the lactic acid. Okay. And it actually, you know, boosts up the vitamin content. It boosts up all of the good immunity in it,
exactly.
So it's so good for your digestive system.
Okay.
And overall health starts in the gut. It's a key to everything.
I agree. Yeah.
So how do we eat it now?
So now, this is a side dish, okay?
Oh,
okay. This is a side dish. So you will have this with a main course or something.
Okay.
So this,
there you go.
So you
we have about 30 seconds left.
Okay. You want to try?
I'll take one.
All right. Just have a bite.
Now, apparently in Korea, instead of saying cheese during a picture, they say
kimchi.
Kimchi!
You know you're Korean.
Yeah, I do.
You've been doing your research.
I have been. Kimchi.
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 Ooh, juicy.
It's juicy, it's crispy, it's crunchy.
I love that it has some flavor to it.
It's that depth and the complexity. It's got fire, it's got sweetness, it's got all different types of textures.
I wouldn't
want to
just eat a cucumber, but this.
It's a cornucopia flavor.
It is.
I love this.
This pops in your mouth.
And it's good for you.
This is delicious.
And it's low in calories, and it gives you all of that flavor.
All right, and you've got to come back and teach us Korean barbecue, okay? You promise?
I definitely will.
All right. I cannot wait. This is fantastic.
Yes.
Thank you.
We'll be right back with more
Rise
Entertainment 360.
한국 사람들은 한식을 세계화를 위해 무엇이든지 번역하고 서구화하려고 애쓰는 것 같다. 고추장도 매운 소스라고 번역하고 된장도 한국식 미소라고 설명한다. 서구인은 쉽게 받아들일지 몰라도 고유의 정체성을 잃는다. 한국 방식 그대로의 모습을 지켜야 한다. 아이언셰프 UK에서도 김밥을 스시라고 주장하는 심사위원들에게 항의했으며 비빔밥, 칼국수, 삼계탕으로 경쟁해 우승컵을 거머쥐었습니다. 주디주는 음식을 그 나라의 문화를 투영하는 상징이라고 말하고 있습니다. 한식에는 한국인의 밝고 불같이 뜨겁고 직설적이며 톡톡 쏘고 근성이 강한 성향이 그대로 드러난다고 합니다. 김치만 해도 그 안에 한국인이 담겨있는데 김치를 동사로 표현할 수 있다고 하며 김치하다는 무엇이든 할 수 있다라는 뜻의 동사에 가깝다고 말합니다. 즉, 김치는 무슨 채소로도 담을 수 있으며 김치로 무슨 음식이든 만들 수 있기 때문이죠. 이것은 한국인들이 무엇이든 잘하는 것과 유사하며 긴 시간의 발효 과정을 견뎌낸 후 풍미를 간직하는 음식도 흔치 않은데 한국인들도 그와 비슷하다는 겁니다. 역사상 많은 우여곡절을 겪었지만 정체성을 잘 간직하여 발전해 나가고 있기 때문이라고 합니다. 주디주 역시 문화적으로나 커리어로나 복잡한 여정을 거쳤으면서도 한국인으로서의 정체성만큼은 확실하게 자리 잡고 있는 자랑스러운 한국인인 것 같습니다. 시청해주셔서 감사합니다. 원다였습니다.